Good morning, everyone. Today we continue with the gastrointestinal disorder, mainly with the chronic peptic ulcers, mainly in the gastric and duodenal ulcers. Chronic peptic ulcers would mean either gastric or duodenal ulcers, the two major forms of peptic ulcer disease of the upper GI tract. Etiology, when we look at the etiology, disturbance in the normal protective mucosa barrier by acid pepsin. This is the one of the main reason. But for this disturbance, there are a lot of causes, mainly H. pylori bacteria, Helicobacter pylori, then NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, acid pepsin secretions, then even the gastritis can cause chronic peptic ulcers, other local irritants, dietary factors, the consumption of high deep fried fats or even the non-veg and very low fiber intake or even zero fibers or even the products which are mainly made out of white, mainly we say maida, even psychological factors, genetic factors, and it is very commonly seen in blood group O. Then even monozygotic twins, it is one of the commonest condition, and sometimes it is associated with HLA-B5 antigen. Even hormonal factors also play a major role in induction of chronic peptic ulcers. When we look at the pathogenesis, exposure of mucosa to the gastric acid and pepsin secretion and strong etiologic association with H. pylori infection. Now recently the medical science has made a clear word that the main cause for gastritis or even gastric irritation is the high amount of presence of H. pylori bacteria. When you look at the duodenal ulcers, the role of high acid pepsin secretions, hypersecretion of the gastric acid into the fasting stomach. So at night, which takes place under the influence of vagal stimulation. So on an empty stomach, or there is a clearance of the stomach to the duodenum, there is a pain takes place in case of duodenal ulcers. Patients of duodenal ulcer have rapid emptying of the stomach. H. pylori is seen in 95% to 100% cases of duodenal ulcers. When you look at the gastric ulcers due to increased serum gastric levels in response to ingested food in an stomach. Patients of gastric ulcer have low to normal gastric acid levels. They have protective gastric mucosa barrier against the acid pepsin is deranged in case of gastric ulcers. H. pylori is commonly seen in 75% to 80% of the patients of gastric ulcers. When we look into the morphological features, grossly, typical peptic ulcers are commonly solitary, nearly 80%, very small, 1 to 2.5 centimeter in diameter, round to oval in shape, and characteristically they are punched out. Benign ulcers usually have flat margins in level with the surrounding mucosa. The ulcers may vary in depth from being superficial, conformed to mucosa, to deep ulcers. When we look at into the microscopical picture of chronic peptic ulcers, have four histological zone and changes. Necrotic zone, which lies in the floor of the ulcer and is connecting necrotic debris and a few leukocytes. Superficial exudative zone lies underneath the necrotic zone, show coagulative necrosis. Granulation tissue zone is seen merging into the necrotic zone, and zone of cicatrization is seen merging into thick layer of granulation tissue. There are some thrombosed or sclerotic arteries may cross the ulcer, which on erosion may result in hemorrhage, bleeding. Complications of these peptic ulcers are obstruction, development of fibrous scar at or near the pylorus results in pyloric stenosis. In the case of yield duodenal ulcer, it causes duodenal stenosis.
yield ulcers along the lesser curvatures may produce hourglass deformity due to fibrosis and contraction. Hemorrhage is one of the complications that may leads to iron deficiency anemia. Severe bleeding may cause coffee ground vomitus or even melena, means the blood in the stools can be seen. That condition is called as melena. So the stools will be tarry dark or dark tarry black in color. A penetrating chronic ulcer may erode a major artery, example left gastric or gastroduodenal or splenic artery, and cause a massive and severe hematemesis and sometimes death. Hematemesis is nothing but that is vomiting of the blood, so the food products or whatever is vomitous look like coffee ground in color. So the other complications like perforation, it may, the contents of the stomach may get perforated to the peritoneal cavity and may cause peritonitis, and even it may changes into malignant transformation, that is it may cause even the cancer. Clinical features, mainly the pain will be there, vomiting, hematemesis and melena. Diet, weight, deep tenderness. See, diet is the sense, the correction of the diet is very very important, and weight, there will be a weight loss. And deep tenderness, whenever we do palpation of the abdomen, there will be a deep tenderness. So when you look at the histological picture, when we look at through the microscopy, we can see the particular layers. So first there is a intact mucosa, then there is a granulation of the tissue zone, then necrotic zone, then ulcerated mucosa, how the tissue layer is totally deranged, and there is a zone of cicatrization and superficial exudative. Now let's know something about gastric carcinoma. So when we look at the carcinoma, that is a cancer of the stomach. Incidence, carcinoma of the stomach comprises more than 90% of all gastric malignancies and is the leading cause of cancer related deaths in countries. The highest incidence is between 4th to 6th decade of life. That means in after the 40 up to 60 age, the commonest one, and is twice more common in men than in women. So why it is more common in men? Because of the habits which they cultivate during their adulthood or whatever. So mainly the smoking one could be the cause, or even intake of food, the dietary changes.